In 1982, on the 200th anniversary of the discovery of the Clinton River, Bill Fleming, a staff writer for the Macomb Daily, wrote, "In the late afternoon of Sunday, July 21st, 1782, two small ships sailed northward through Lake St. Clair and rounded what is now called Sunset Point at the mouth of the Clinton River. The ships, manned by a company of 25, turned into the river and began a five-mile journey through the wilderness. The crew anxiously surveyed the banks of the river in search of a suitable landing spot and in anticipation of some unknown evil. A clearing was finally sighted on the south bank where freshwater springs tumbled into the river. The order was given to beach the ships. Thus began the first chapter in the history of white settlers in Macomb County. The Moravians had arrived."
The Moxon Manor is located on a peaceful portion of the Clinton River, at the same site that the Moravian missionaries had selected for their village in 1782. After Henry Harrington's death, his widow, in 1881, sold the property to Isaac Williams. Isaac Williams was a German immigrant who had come with his family at the age of 9. He tilled the soil and made a productive farm until he was able to build a two-story frame house. In 1908, however, he was too feeble to continue farming and sold the property to William Moxon, who was already well known in the area because of his Moxon liniment, which was a miraculous relief for sore muscles, good for man or beast. Mr. Moxon was a pharmacist in Mount Clemens. He originally came from Upton, England, and he had studied at Oxford University. He had wanted to become a doctor, but his wife, Anna, much preferred an occupation that wouldn't require the odd hours and the calls in the middle of the night or any time during the day. He came to America in 1880 and later settled here in Mount Clemens. It was in 1908 that he sold the patent to his famous liniment to John Bennow. It was sold throughout the country, and John Bennow moved the production down to Texas. Moxon, while he was in his retirement, made the Moxon Manor one of the most scenic farms in the area. He built a greenhouse, he stuccoed the exterior, and he enjoyed his retirement. Those who knew William Moxon remember him as a kind, generous, and happy man. That was until 1846 when his wife Anna died. A gloom settled over until his two daughters and granddaughter moved into the house with him. They remained there until 1954 when the property was sold to John Fitzgibbons. And John Fitzgibbons held it for 10 years until he sold it to Mr. and Mrs. Santine. The Santines have sold the property to their daughter, Paul and Barbara Saliba. And in 1984, when digging the foundations for a swimming pool, there were skulls uncovered. The skulls that were uncovered could date back to either the Paleo-Indian era, which occurred after the glaciers left the area, or the Moravian village, or the town of Frederick. This is where the first settlement in Macomb County was established 2 centuries ago.
Why do we study history? Some say to better understand the present. Others say to avoid our past mistakes and better understand the future. Maybe. Or maybe for the sake of the children, so they will better understand where they came from and why they are here. What do you think? Let us know. We'll read the best letter on our next show.
I am glad that we have historic homes such as this that are still used and enjoyed by families today. Do you live in a home whose history you would like to share with the township? We'd enjoy hearing from you. Thank you.